I too would like to thank everyone for turning out tonight. This is a nice turnout, so, and it's a beautiful evening, and I've been informed by somebody that the Twins are on, and it's men's night out at the country club, and so there are some things that kind of draw us away, so thanks everyone for coming out. And what we'd like to do tonight, we'll start out here in just a minute, then just go to find a table, help yourself to some, there's cookies in the back and some juice. And we'll spend about 10 minutes or so. We want everybody to get a chance to talk, but we'll spend about 10 minutes or so, and then we'll rotate to a different table.
At the conclusion of the community roundtables, Jamestown Public School Board members summarized the discussion topics, starting with Superintendent Bob Toso.
And the table that I was at, instructional administrative staffing, and we did ramble, I guess, a little bit on some topics that don't necessarily fit into that area, but some things that did. First of all, at the grade school level, there was concerns about an art program, that the art program at the elementary level is, maybe the word hit and miss would be the most appropriate, and that we perhaps would like to have something a little bit more structured for our elementary students. Foreign language in the elementary schools is something that does not occur, and of course, it's well documented that the earlier kids have access to foreign language programs, the easier it is for them to learn. So, and there was a discussion about how Jamestown College used to bring kids up to the, or bring their respective teachers, I suppose, to the elementary schools to work with kids in an after-school program teaching foreign language. So there was some concern about what happened to that. We had a good discussion on STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and math. Then some other areas where we again had some real good discussions, some concerns about discipline. Good discussion, as I'm sure many tables did, on the rental policy. I think that was a major topic of discussion tonight, but I appreciate people coming in and talking about that. And again, it will be on the agenda on Monday night when we talk about some legal guidance that I've received, as I was directed to do by the board. There was a question asked about the morale of teachers. Then we had an excellent discussion on sexual assault and the workshop that was held here last week and concerns, is the district doing enough to educate, especially our male students, since sexual assaults are generally committed by males? Are we doing enough to educate our males on the issues with sexual assault and working with our kids, in particular athletes, because sometimes that's where sexual assaults do get I think that's what we think of most. Anyway, it seems to be in the news quite a bit.
We didn't generate large numbers as the other groups either. It wasn't that hot of a topic, and we're doing okay, and we're far from the refreshments, so. But things are going well, and we've heard that conveyed from the public that, we don't need to be reactive. We don't spend it forward, and we have good direction. And it was also conveyed that we're frugal and prudent as a board. We don't spend on money we don't have and on things we don't sustain by spending it forward. Also appreciative about the bonding issue, where we're able to pay off the bond from the school. That's the community school. It was we're paying it off near 4 years early, and we're saving taxpayers money. The concern that was probably addressed by other members of the group as far as the building and so forth. So all was good at our table. Thank you.
We basically talked about TANG, which is gift and talented program. We talked about more electives in technology and such at the high school. Math investigation was talked about a bit. Intelligent design was brought up. More thinking in the curriculum. Talked about the current AP classes that are offered, as well as the college dual credit classes. TANG was brought up again. Talked about a tutoring program at the high school. writing skills. There was a concern there, and students had difficulty with writing. And we did have actually extracurricular. We talked about baseball and soccer tournaments that were kind of moved around here this spring in Jamestown. And of course, Mr. Conway had to bring in a couple of stories about past events that happened as well, like moving baseball or moving state tournaments, but that was pretty much it.
I think one of the biggest concerns that was brought forth was that there was some disappointment in how quickly that the board was willing to make a motion in regards to religion and politics. But also at the same time, people were glad that we tabled the decision and that we were gathering information, so I was glad to hear that. We all were glad that Mr. Noel was here. He gave us some input on how the rentals are handled at the high school. He felt that he did the right thing with the rental, with the group that was here not too long ago. We discussed rentals of the high school. Someone had mentioned they thought it's a beautiful facility. It should be utilized to its maximum potential. Wondered if it was. We don't publicly advertise that we have a facility to rent out, although Mr. Noel says it's really quite busy, and he and Mr. Rosen are plenty busy with handling rentals and events as it is, and also people need to remember that when we do rent the space out, that there is a need for custodial work, and a lot of that comes out of the rentals that we get. But that's always something that people need to keep in mind. Someone else asked, how much advance notice do people do we need to have if they want to rent the facility? And that varies, but it could be as much as a year out. And we talked about repairs. There was a question about the community facility that's being organized, and we didn't have a lot of answers for that, unfortunately. I think that Mr. Tolso or Mindy would probably have a little bit more input on that, but just kind of wondering how it's going to be run. There was some discussion on it's a public facility, and I hope that people use their sense in terms of being creative and how do we share its usage in the community, that the hours are creative and usable for all of its patrons, and that it's poorly managed as some other facilities in town where you don't have a lot of access to using the facility. And also the biggest concern, I think, is that it's going to be a great facility if it ever happens, but we don't want it to be a compromise in the present programming and facilities that we have at school right now. We don't want it to be like totally run by the high school, because we have a lot of other needs too, so you could probably speak more on that, but that's kind of what we talked about.
We had a discussion about intelligent design being considered part of the curriculum at the high school. More than one view being presented. We talked about offering electives or other classes, keep students in after 2 o'clock, 1:30 that time, more hands-on technical type things. Had a discussion about are we teaching the students to critically think? That was an interesting conversation. We had a concern about the intersection right south of the middle school here, where the bike rack is off school property. Well, it's on school property, but it's across the street. It's not on the same block as us. We talked about snow removal at the schools. Sometimes we feel that people feel that the snow is being removed when students are coming to school. Talked about a stoplight or a caution light up by the high school, 12th Avenue and 10th Street, especially at the beginning of the day and the end of the day. We talked about concern about the board having quick action instead of doing background work, but in line with Robert Rules of Order, you have to make motions and seconds to bring up discussions. That's it.
Thanks everyone again for coming out. This was a great turnout.